looking everywhere, haven't found her yet. She's the big affair I cannot forget. Only girl I ever think of with regret.
I'd like to add his initial to my monogram. Tell me, where is the shepherd for this lost lamb?
There's a somebody I'm longing to see. I hope that she turns out to be someone to watch over me.
I'm a little lamb who's lost in the wood. I know I could always be good to one who'll watch over me.
Although I may not be the man some girls think of as handsome, but to her heart I'll carry the key.
Won't you tell him please to put on some speed? Follow my lead. Oh, how I need someone to watch over.
Someone to watch over me.
Gentlemen, I'm Catherine, and this is...
Matthew.
And we have Peter on the piano. And tonight, we are celebrating love and singing all sorts of songs from musical theater that talk about experiencing love, falling in, falling out, and everything in between.
And I am going to sweep her off her feet. I'm gonna try.
I'm already swept.
Oh, well. Story of my life. Well, you know, from the first moments that we are on this earth, we're dependent upon each other. We're all looking for someone to watch over us. Think of how dependent a newborn baby is. Perhaps this explains why we're all seeking friendship and love so completely.
Where is love? Does it fall from skies above? Is it underneath the willow tree that I've been dreaming of? Where is she who I close my eyes to see? Will I ever know the sweet hello that's meant for only me? Who can say where she may be? My
must I travel far and wide till I am beside the someone who I can mean something to? Where is love?
Heart, don't fail me now. Courage, don't desert me. Don't hold back now that we're here. People always say life is full of choices. No one ever mentions fear or how the world can seem so vast on this journey to the past. Somewhere down this road, I know someone's waiting. Years of dreams just can't be wrong. Arms will open wide, I'll be safe and wanted, finally home where I belong. Well, starting now, I'm moving fast on this journey to the past.
One hope, then another. Who knows where this road may go? Back to who I was, on to find my future, things my heart still needs to know. Yes, let this be a sign. Let this road be mine. Let it lead me to my past and bring me home.
I know, look at that.
Thank you.
How do you begin to define love? Poets and lyricists, composers, playwrights, and philosophers have been trying to do that for years.
As have scientists and psychologists.
And once you've passed the point of puberty and are ready for a romantic relationship, there's nothing like looking into that person's eyes.
Up here, Matthew. Oh.
And getting that special feeling.
Yes, according to scientists, it takes between 90 seconds and 4 minutes to decide if you have that special connection with someone.
Ten minutes ago I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling. You gave me the feeling the room had no ceiling or floor. 10 minutes ago I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her, she's an angel, with the dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
10 minutes ago, I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bell and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found him. I have found him. We are dancing, we are flying. Oh, and he's taking me back to the skies.
In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth.
You didn't want to.
Okay, well, the song's over.
Well, we'll call this stage of love butterflies. You've all felt it now, haven't you? This involves intense infatuation and sexual attraction. Your body responds chemically, making oxytocin a bonding hormone. Dopamine, which is an antidepressant.
Dopamine,
serotonin.
Dopamine.
Oh yes,
dopamine.
Thank you.
You're
just like my ex-wife always correcting me. serotonin, which gives you high self-esteem. I have lots of that. And opiates, which give you something of a high.
When I worked at the mill, weaving at the loom, I'd gaze absent-minded at the roof. And half the time the shuttle would tangle in the threads and the warp would get mixed with the woof. If I loved you. But somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be. If I loved you, time and again, I would try to say all I'd want you to know. If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way.
I would try to say all I'd want you to know. If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way. Round in circles I'd go, longing to tell you, but afraid and shy. I'd let my golden chances pass me by. Soon you'd leave me, off you would go in the mist of day. Never to Maria, every sight that I see is Maria.
Tony, Tony.
Always you, every thought I'll ever know. Everywhere I go, you'll be you and me.
Afraid.
They are strict with me, please.
Good night.
Buenas noches.
I love you.
Yes, hurry. Tony, when
Tomorrow.
I work at the bridal shop. Come there.
At sundown.
Good night.
Good night.
Tony, wait!
Shh.
Come to the back door.
See. Good night. Good night. Sleep well, and when you dream, dream of me.
My one time to play that part. So it's so good to see so many familiar faces here. Can we get the house lights on for a second? Thank you. Hi, I know like thank you all for being here. So this next song, one of the first leading roles I got to play was Nanette in No No Nanette at the Golden Apple. And I also, the first show I ever did with Bob Tristellini was 42nd Street. And I'm gonna ask him, and he has no idea I'm doing this, to come up on stage. So I'm kind of combining those two shows because this song, T for Two, is from No No Nanette. And in 42nd Street, there's a lot of tap dancing. And we're gonna sort of improvise a soft shoe when the dance portion comes. You ready for this?
Sure.
And if you want to, do you know T for Two?
Yeah.
So we can sing it like a duet.
I have no breath.
I'll start. Okay, take some deep breaths. I'll start, okay?
Picture me upon your knee, just T for Two,
and Two for T, just me for you, and you for me alone.
He knows it very well.
Nobody near us to see us or hear us, no friends or relations, on weekend vacations.
I won't have no dear that we own a telephone, dear.
Day will break, and I will wake,
and start to bake a sugar cake for me to take for all the boys to see.
A girl for me, can't you see how happy we will be?
All right, now here we go. You ready? Look at him go! I'm like trying to... Look at him go! I'm not even like...
You wait.
Oh. You guys wait. We'll see what happens next.
Everything went wrong. and the whole day long I'd feel so blue. For the longest while I'd forgot to smile. Then I met you. Now that my blue days have passed, now that I've found you at last. He kicked me out of his house. We used to live together. But I'll always love you. Have a seat now. I'll be loving you always, with the love that's true always. When the things you've planned, they need a helping hand, I will understand always, always. Days may not be fair always, that's when I'll be there always. Not for just an hour, not for just a day, not for just a year, but very nice.
And Mom. So this next stage of love we're going to talk about is called building. This is when you move past infatuation and you start to build a relationship. It's marked by a sort of happy anxiety and you're unable to focus.
Yes, the body begins to act as if you were on drugs. The monoamine neurotransmitters speed up the heart rate. Why do I get all the big words?
Because you're pretty.
I am. This triggers rushes of pleasure and then mimic the effects of Class A drugs. Now, during this time, Peter, it's hard to sleep. I'm just saying that because you look a little tired these days. You're literally kept awake thinking about the other person.
It's like you're drunk on love.
No more talk of darkness. Forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here. Nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you.
All I ask is every waking moment, tone my head with talk of
your freedom. Let me be your light. You're safe. No one will find you. Your fears are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night, and you always beside me to hold me and to hide me.
Then say share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. Say you'll need Anywhere you go, let me go too. Christine, that's all I ask of you. Night, each morning.
Say you love me.
You know I do. Love me, that's all I ask of you.
Shoes untied. Hey, you can't leave. No, you can't leave because I've been so taken away by your beauty that I didn't know my shoe was untied. But seriously, I have kissed more women on stage than off stage, that's for sure. But I always fall deeply in love with my leading lady. And you know, let me just tell you, some of you may not know this about me, but in my personal life, well, I'm a bit of a romantic. Well, and this song, which I'm about to sing, is probably the most romantic song I've ever heard. And I believe it is going to express just why I have fallen so deeply in love with Catherine. You ask me why I fell in love with you. I'm going to tell you the truth, dear. I'm going to tell her the truth. The reason why I fell in love with you is because, my darling, I find that you always bring to my mind a certain someone I have loved since before I caught a tooth. You remind me of my mother. My mother was a lot like you. So many little things you do, I find they bring to mind my mother. I never thought there'd be another would have that sweet appeal that could make me feel that the old fool world was real. I got a tin type of my mother. When mother was a girl like you, you look a lot alike, you too. Her hair was just as fair, her eyes used to twinkle just the way that your eyes do. You remind me of my mother, that's why I love you. Where'd she go?
I don't know, it worked with my ex-wife.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah, well, that explains it.
Well, do you know that a healthy relationship can foster physical and mental health? Oh, well, this explains. I've been single for 10 years. someone who is in a healthy relationship is the beautiful Mrs. Catherine Parks. She's gonna come out and do a number for you. I'm gonna go have a donut.
Days can be sunny with never a sigh. Don't need what money can buy. Birds in the trees sing their days full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I'm chipper all the day, happy with my lot. How did I get that way? Look at what I've got. I got rhythm, I got music, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Old man Trouble, I don't mind him, you won't find him around my door. I got starlight, I got sweet dreams, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more?
For here you are standing there, loving me, whether or not you should.
So somewhere in my youth or childhood, I must have done something good.
Nothing comes from nothing. Nothing ever could.
So somewhere in my youth
or childhood,
I must have done something.
Something good.
Thank you.
Matthew take you all into intermission. And I just want to say it has been a real treat working with him and doing all these love songs and looking deep into each other's eyes. But I have to say I'm a little concerned because I fear that Matthew thinks that I am like wildly in love with him. When the truth is, I just like him.
Well, we're wonders never cease. I didn't like her. I couldn't stand her. I wouldn't have her. I never knew her, but now I do, and I could, and I would, and I know. She loves me, and to my amazement, I love it. Knowing that she loves me, she loves me. True, she doesn't show it. How could she when she doesn't know it? Yesterday she loved me, bah! Now today she likes me, ha! And tomorrow, woo! Ah! My teeth ache from the urge to touch her. I'm trembling. What the hell does that mean? I want her, that's because I love her. And matters are improving daily. Yesterday I loved her too, now today I love her, woo. And tomorrow, ah, tingling, such delicious tingles. I'm trembling. What the hell does that mean? I'm freezing. Oh, that's because it's cold out. But still I'm incandescent and like some adolescent, I'd like to squall on every wall I see. She loves me. She loves me.
take a chance now for romance now. Tell us someone that you care.
We're calling assimilation. Once you move past the physical, you have to decide if this person really fits into your life. Do you have clashing boundaries, similar goals, ideologies? This stage is crucial to deciding if you can make it past infatuation and really go the distance. Holding you close against my skin and pulling you inside me. Suddenly there's a world I never knew. Feeling your skin, you're now the world. It evermore divides me before and after. At once erased the lines and walls around me. How did you know exactly what to do? Feeling your fingers on my waist, I know my fate has found me before and after.
First time in my life, I am not outside the moment, with a camera in between me and the world I think I know. For the first time in my life, I am somehow part of something. You surround me, you connect me, and I think I can't let go. For the first time in my life, you have opened up a channel. There is nothing to contain us. We are joined and we are free. For the first time in my life, I am risking something precious. I am asking you, Francesca, come with me. I can't tell you I know what the future will be. Who knows anything? I just look at those eyes. You've got so much to see. Let me show you, there's crowds and camels and hillsides to climb. All I know is in all of the time, from man's first breath to God's last warning, you and I are just 1 second spinning by in one split second. You and I have just 1 second and a million miles to go. I don't need to be rich. I don't need something new.
I don't want to go back to a world without.
my whole life was you.
I love this.
Please just look at me. You were born with a wondrous soul. This is how you begin to be whole. The world keeps burning, stars keep turning, and you and I are just one second spinning by in just one second. You and I have just one second and a million miles to go. Tell you I know what the answer will be. It's impossible, but this thing, this is bigger than what we can see. This is destiny. We are tied, we are locked, we are bound. This will not be reversed or unwound. Whatever fate the stars are weaving, we're not breaking. I'm not leaving, and you and I are just one second spinning by in just one second. You and I have just one second
and a million miles to go.
And a million miles to go.
That was fun.
Was from Bridges of Madison County by Jason Robert Brown. And that I listened to that song and I loved it so much. I was like, I have to do a cabaret with a guy so I can sing that song. And I gotta do it with him. So
thank you.
So lucky me that I found him.
Lucky me, she found me. But love, oh, that's right, it's my turn.
Yes,
right.
It's your turn.
Yeah, this should be easy for me to remember. This is where I tell you that heartache and rejection, unrequited love, some of you have experienced that, and you all know that it can actually cause physical pain in the body. After all this time without you, after all this time, I find that it's still no use to say to myself, out of sight, out of mind.
my love for you should have faded long ago. I wish I didn't need your kiss. Why must your kiss torture me as long as this? I might be smiling by now with some new tender friend, smiling by now with my heart on the mend. But when I try, something in that heart says no. You're still there. I wish I didn't love you so. The future's here, the past is dead. I won't dissect or weigh it, but something small's been left unsaid, and now's the time to say it. You're not my first, as well you know. Once before I leapt when marriage beckoned, but yours always so much more than first. You are the first to be second.
I screwed up too. I made a vow which lasted 40 years less than I reckoned. But lucky for you, cause starting now, you can be first to be second.
So what if we had bubbles that got burst?
All of those mistakes are in the past.
I don't care if you are not my first, as long as you're the first to be my last.
I'd better be.
Here's to our firsts. We learned a lot. Our future will be gloriously fecund. Now we'll make each second count. From now on, my first to be second comes first. Of course, after you've been together for a while, the real you starts to emerge, right?
Yeah.
Yes, and you start to see all those annoying faults. You don't have any, though.
None!
And of course, this brings the stress and anxiety that can come with a relationship, not to mention conflict. We'll have an old-fashioned wedding, blessed in the good old-fashioned way. I'll vow to love you forever. You'll vow to love and honor and obey. Somewhere in some little chapel, someday when orange blossoms bloom, we'll have an old-fashioned wedding, a simple wedding for an old-fashioned bride and groom.
I want a wedding in a big church with bridesmaids and flower girls, a lot of ushers in tailcoats, reporters and photographers, a ceremony with a bishop who will tie the knot and say, do you agree to love and honor? Love and honor, yes, but not obey. I want a wedding ring surrounded by diamonds and platinum, a big reception at the Waldorf with champagne and caviar. I want a wedding like the Vanderbilts had, everything big, not small. If I can't have that kind of a wedding, I don't want to get married at all.
We'll have an old-fashioned wedding, blessed in the good old-fashioned way. I'll vow to love you forever. You'll vow to love and honor and obey. Somewhere in some little chapel, someday when orange blossoms bloom, we'll have an old-fashioned wedding, a simple wedding for an old-fashioned bride and groom. We'll have an old-fashioned wedding. Here's a word for you. Commitment. The initial butterflies have long worn off, and you know that their eyes aren't made from stardust, and their heart is not built from the dreams of pixies. Catherine wrote that. But somehow, despite all their faults and their annoyances, they've managed to become your best friend. But that doesn't mean that the eye doesn't wander from time to time. And what happens when you reach your midlife crisis? Right here you see one of the good guys.
one of the nice ones with sensible drives. What else could I be? I'm one of the good guys who play with their children and dote on and pamper their wives. But there was a night in Hawaii on a business trip that my mind has suffused with a mystic glow. She was someone's friend and she had this smile. We were on a beach and we walked a while, and I watched the wind billow in her hair, and I knew we knew there was more to share. I could feel the ground start to go like volcanoes starting to blow, and the waves were loud. We were all alone. We had left the crowd. Not a soul would ever have known. But I stopped and said no, 'cause that isn't me. I'm one of the good guys, one of the smart ones whose virtue survives. Firm as a tree, one of the good guys who trades a flash of heat to build a warmer fire, denies himself a treat to shoot for something higher, and that's the part that's sweet, that only the good guys know. That's not the end. As you suspected, time flipped some pages. I'm now 44. There's money to spend. The kids are in college. My wife's back in art school. We just bought a house at the shore. But sometimes at night, in the stillness, lying wide awake, as the wife I still desire sleeps by my side, I can feel the wash of the perfumed air as my mind is drowning in billowing hair. And although I know that my life is blessed, I'm teased by thoughts that it's second best. And the visions seethe in my head of the lives that I could have led. They are all still there. I can change my fate. There's no time to spare. I must find them before it's too late. But I wake and say no. Oh, hell, why defend all of us good guys strangling in plenty, yet whining for more? Truth is, my friends, just between good guys, it's not which road you take, which life you pick to live in. Whichever choice you make, the longing is a given. And that's what brings the ache, that only the good guys know.
Gentlemen, hasn't Peter Madpak been amazing? So my husband is here tonight. Jonathan, I think I saw you over there with the bald head. And when he wears a hat, I cannot find him anywhere.
we've been together now, we've been married for nearly 7 years. And we've been together for probably 10 or 11 years now. And I was recently being interviewed on TV for something, and someone said, tell me about, you know, you and Jonathan. And I said, this was like 4 months ago. Well, we've been together for 4 years. And I was like, oh my God, that's wrong. But in the theater world, you don't like correct, you just keep going. So I didn't even think to be like, oh, actually what I meant to say was 7 years, blah, blah. So I just kept going, and I was like, whatever, maybe he won't see it. So he saw it. But what I meant to say was that we've been together, it only feels like 4 years, because we're so in love still. Yes. So I did it on purpose. It was a compliment. With that said, I have a song I'd like to sing. What makes me love him? It's not his singing. I've heard his singing. It sours the milk, and yet it's gotten to the point where I prefer that kind of milk. What makes me love him? It's not his learning. He's learned so slowly his whole life long, and though he really knows a multitude of things, they're mostly wrong. He's not romantic, and yet I love him. No one occasion he's used me ill, and though he's handsome, I know inside me, were he a plain man, I'd love him still. What makes me love him? It's quite beyond me. It must be something I can't define, unless it's merely that he's masculine, and that he's
the experts say it does not last. The experts say it's fleeting. The experts pray love fades so fast. Then tell me, why is my heart still beating? Shouldn't I be less in love with you? Shouldn't I address what time can do? Shouldn't I be more inclined to flee? Shouldn't I explore all I can be? Shouldn't I confess a sordid fling? Shouldn't I caress a cute young thing? Shouldn't I assess what we've been through? Shouldn't I be less in love with you? After 30 years together, all those brutal fights, those futile fights, and the sleepless nights. Sh-
Shouldn't I have quit? 'Cause marriage ends. Shouldn't I have split like all our friends? Shouldn't I profess it's time to go? Shouldn't I be less in love with you? No.
You might need to stretch your legs. If you've been with the person you love, whether they're still here or in the afterlife, if you've been with the person you love for 15 years, stand up. Stand up. 15 years, yeah. All right, now, if you haven't been together 30 years, you can take a seat. Wow. Wow. If you've been together for more than 40 years or more, stay standing. 40 years. Wow. All right. How about 50 years or more? 50 years or more. Wow. 60? 60 years or more. All right. Oh, wow, right there. Oh, we need to give them a flower.
Think you all could teach us a thing or two about love.
Yes. Well, you know, Catherine, we've been singing a lot of love songs. I'm afraid that people may talk.
Why do they think up stories that link my name with yours?
Why do the neighbors chatter all day behind their doors?
Of don'ts for you.
Don't praise my charm too much.
Don't look so vain with me.
Don't stand in the rain with me. People will say we're in love. Don't take my arm too much.
Don't keep your hand in mine.
Your hand, it feels so grand in mine. People will say we're in love. Don't dance all night with me till the stars fade from above. They'll see it's all right with me. People will say we're in love.
Well, we want to thank all of you for being here tonight, and we'd certainly like to thank up in the booth Jasmine and Jacqueline and Amy. Woo-hoo! At the bar.
Woo-hoo!
And the incredible Peter Madcap. Madcap. And then we just want to thank one person in particular. He's so supportive. He comes and sees us in everything, and not only that, he brings flowers all the time. So Peter Selesky, when these flowers are for you.
I knew he had flowers back there.
Thank you so much. Put these right over here. Well, just because you have been together for a long time, that doesn't mean a special experience can't take you right back to that feeling of butterflies.
Yeah, be spontaneous. Don't be predictable. Spice things up a little bit. And whatever you do, don't forget to be grateful for the person that you love. There was love all around, but I never heard it singing. No, I never heard it at all till there was you. How about that Peter Madpack?
Oh, he's so great.
Peter Madpack.
There was love all around, but I never heard it singing. No, I never heard it at all till there was you.
Thank you. You know, Catherine, there is one song we haven't done. You know that song?
Oh, a song.
That song.
We should do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You all don't mind?
Once in every show, there comes a song like this. It starts off soft and low and ends up with a kiss. Oh, where is the song that goes like this? Where is it? Where?
A sentimental song that casts a magic spell. They all will hum along. We'll overact like hell.
Oh, where is the song that goes like this?
Where?
Now we can go straight into the middle eight. A bridge that is too far for me.
I'll sing it in your face while we both embrace.
And then we change the key. Now we're into A. That's awfully high for me.
And everyone can see we should have stayed in D.
For this is our song that goes like this. I'm feeling very proud.
You're singing far too loud.
That's the way that this song goes.
You're standing on my toes.
Singing our song that goes like this.
I can't believe there's more.
It's far too long, I'm sure.
That's the trouble with this song.
It goes on and on and on. For this is our song that is too long.
Oh, come on, Peter, they want to go home.
We're singing this till dawn.
You'll wish that you weren't born.
Let's stop that damn refrain
before we go and sing the song. Always ends like this.
Thank you.